Physio Voice. Today's Physio Funda is on a topic, Corset Hypothesis or Core Hypothesis, and which is very popular within the physio community and is always up for discussion. So what today we are going to see is that what exactly it means by Corset or Core Hypothesis and how it has evolved over time. So first, take the principle on which Corset Hypothesis was based. Was the principle of anticipatory postural adjustments, which by definition are small movements which occur automatically prior to any postural perturbation to the body. For example, if I am going to do the movement of sit to stand, so prior to just getting up from the bed, the first muscle to be activated would be the gastroceleus muscle in the leg, which would prevent my forward fall when I stand up. So taking this as a reference, Richardson was the person who gave the Corset or the Core Hypothesis, and he said that through this hypothesis he emphasized the importance of transversus abdominis muscle or the core muscle in stabilizing the spine. And what he said was transversus abdominis acted as a corset, encircling, protecting and stiffening the spine in relation to any postural perturbation. But the main point of his theory was that the transversus abdominis activation happened in a bilateral co-contraction manner irrespective of the direction of the perturbation. And he used the example of arm movement. So irrespective of whether the arm is moved in a straight or a diagonal manner, or whether a single or both the arms are lifted, the transversus abdominis would always act in a bilateral co-contraction manner. And up until a point, this Corset hypothesis was very popular. And in conditions like low back pain, where the inherent mechanism of core activation was found to be deficient, tummy tucking as an exercise to activate the core or the transversus abdominis muscle was very popular. But as more research was done into the concept of core, it was realized that this transversus abdominis activation, which happens bilaterally, is actually more energy consuming to the body. So it is less chance that it would be preferred by the body. Secondly, it is not transversus abdominis co-activation does not form the part of a normal motor pattern by the brain, because since it is an APA, anticipatory postural adjustment, it forms the part of a natural balance mechanism, and it bilateral activation of TRA is not a part of a certain motor pattern. Instead, what it was found that transversus abdominis acted in an asymmetrical manner during a single arm movement, and there was a reciprocal activation of TRA with internal oblique muscle, which created a torque opposite to that created by the arm movement, which helped stabilize the spine. And to further support this, it was found that the ipsilateral transversus abdominis muscle actually acted as an inhibitory APA when doing unilateral arm movement. Now the question is, why doing this pattern of TRA activation is important and how it will help us with treatment and assessment of patients? Well, basically transversus abdominis activation as an APA is automatic in nature. So it is not a peripheral process, but rather it has a central processing component. And as it forms the part of normal balance mechanism, training it voluntarily by doing tummy tucking is doubtful. A more appropriate way to target core activation or to strengthen core muscles would be to actually perform the function or the activity in which it is found that this automatic activation of core is slightly impaired.
To summarize, in light of the evidence available about core, it is high time we think twice before giving voluntary tummy tuck in as an exercise for core activation. Thank you.